Morning becomes eclectic. It is 89.9 KCRW as we come up on just about 24 minutes after 11. I'm Nic Harcourt, your host. We're running a little bit late this morning because of our Lamac session, but let's see. We've got Tom, Tim, and Richard back in the studio. Collectively, they are Keane. Welcome back, guys.
Hello.
Congratulations. New record just came out.
Yes, we're very excited.
Want to talk about that a little bit later on. You know, the first time we met you, we just sort of went back and did a quick look because I thought you'd been here three times. Apparently, this is actually the fourth time here. And November 11th, 2003, first time, before the first album even came out in the States, I do believe. I want to talk about that time and what's been going on in between and obviously the new album in a short while. But we'll throw it over to you guys to start off with. It's a set of music, our guests back in studio. It's Keane.
Hey, we're a band called Keane here on Nic Harcourt's show on KCRW, and this is a song that's called Nothing in My Way. Hey, we're called Keane, and we'd like to say a big hello to everyone in Los Angeles, California, America, across the world. Thank you for listening to us here on KCRW. Here's a song called Crystal Ball. Thank you. Hey, this is Keane here with Nic Harcourt on Morning Becomes Eclectic on KCRW. We're going to take it down a bit now and play a song off our new record called Hamburg Song.
Well, you see me in the end, or is it just a waste of time trying to be your friend? Just shine, 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 shine a little light, shine a light on my life and warm me. I wonder if you know yourself at all. You know that it could be so simple. I lay myself down to make it so, but you don't want to know. You take much more than I'd ever ask for. My day, you think that you could see your way to lay yourself down and make it so? But you don't want to know. You take much more than I'd ever ask for.
Our guests in studio this morning are Keane. Again, welcome back, guys. Thanks for playing the new stuff. Looking forward to hearing the whole of the new album, which we just got a copy of yesterday, just a couple of advanced tracks up until now. But I should thank a couple of you guys for coming in back in February, I think, and playing us a couple of those songs. Well, let's see. Where do we start? November 2003, you guys first came to visit us. And I remember it was some demos or a single, I guess, that we'd been playing from Fierce Panda. Does that make sense?
Yeah, I think it would have been Everybody's Changing, which actually we re-released a kind of about a year later. But when we were out that time, I think it was only out on Fierce Panda, and we were just incredibly excited because, you know, everyone seemed to be kind of taking to this song, and you know, it was opening up all these chances, you know, such as coming on here. So it was great.
And I remember that night, I think you played at the Troubadour, and this time around it's a little bit different. The venues are a little bit bigger this time around, although you're telling me you're going to be in New York, I think, tomorrow for a show at the Bowery Ballroom. So you still like doing those small shows, which is kind of cool.
Yeah, we love it. You know, I think especially with this record, we wanted to kind of take ourselves right back down to being in that kind of environment of playing kind of sweaty rock venues and kind of giving everything a feeling of kind of exclusivity and excitement. And it's really worked so far. We had a great show at the Henry Fonda last night in LA, and the people just loved it. So it seems to be working out well. The new songs are going down well, so we're very happy.
We're talking with Tom, who's the singer of the band. Tim is here as well, and Richard. And let's talk about the new album, because obviously, first time around, people always talk about you got the whole of your life to write that first album. And then second album sometimes takes a little longer, some hiccups maybe, but you guys seem to have just sort of jumped straight into moving forward with the sound of Keane. Tell us about this album. There's a lot more going on this new record.
We definitely had it in our heads that we wanted to do something new and try and, you know, push ourselves forward as much as we possibly could, but it definitely wasn't an easy and smooth process by any means. I mean, even writing the songs on the road is just something that comes as a bit of a shock. You know, like you say, you have years and years and no sort of pressure or expectation or anything when you're writing the songs for the first record.
That end up becoming a first record, right?
Yeah. And, you know, so writing on a tour bus and stuff, that took a bit of getting used to. But I think it made, you know, for me, writing it certainly changed the way I was writing. And I think you can feel that there's a difference in the songs on this record. And it, you know, it was the same being in the studio. There was a lot of kind of disagreements about how we wanted to change the sound and how we wanted the songs to work out. So, but you know, that's that kind of conflict. And
well, what kind of conversations were you guys having?
Tim was kind of saying,
unless you don't want to bring it up again.
No. You know, it was things like
part of the fun of it, really, isn't it?
Yeah, your drums are rubbish. That kind of stuff.
No drums on the new record.
I think what it was it was about experimenting and discovering. You know, and along the way, you know, you do get frustrated and tear your hair out. I think, you know, for example, with the vocals, you know, I think it took a long time before I kind of really felt that I got the singing right on the record. But when I got into the zone, it just came very freely and very naturally. You know. What one thing we did with the singing, you know, instead of kind of hanging out in a kind of really sterile vocal booth with a pair of headphones on, I went into the control room, you know, every producer's worst nightmare, and sang the vocals, you know, with the track playing in the background and everyone in the studio, you know, just to get a kind of a feeling of kind of rawness and performance to it. You know, and it was little things like that, you know, and obviously, you know, in terms of the sound of the piano, Tim really kind of experimented with the boxes and things he was putting it through. So it was things like that that just took a while to kind of take shape. And you know, there was frustration and conflict along the way, but the end result is something that we feel really kind of pushed ourselves and pushed our boundaries as a band, which I think is the most you can ask for, really.
It's interesting doing this interview as well, because first time around they didn't let you talk.
Who didn't? Ourselves, probably. Well, we used to. I mean, you know, we used to get incredibly nervous, and I think one of the things we felt with Hopes and Fears is that we didn't talk enough about the record. You know, where the songs came from. We didn't kind of let people know enough about ourselves. And I think with this record, we have a very kind of strong set of beliefs about what the record's about, and you know, and who we are. And we really want to let people know that in a kind of clearer way as possible. So you know, we're very chatty and ask away these days.
You know, Tim, Tom was just talking about you experimenting with the things that you can do with that piano and with various pianos, I'm guessing. Tell us a little bit about that and expand upon that idea. For those who don't know, there's no guitar player in this band. So you do a lot of other stuff on the keyboards. Tell us what you experimented with for the new record.
Well, I think just, you know, we toured and toured and toured with Hopes and Fears, and one of the great joys for me as a kind of music geek traveling around the world was visiting, like, you know, the sort of American thrift stores and picking up all these vintage effects pedals and stuff from like the 70s and 60s and 50s that nobody ever really uses anymore. And we just kind of hit upon the idea of putting the piano through all these effects pedals and just seeing what came out. And because, as far as I know, nobody's ever done that before. It seems kind of obvious.
Can you tell us a couple in particular that worked, something that you'd never done before?
Well, there's a great, like, the sound on Is It Any Wonder, which is a sort of Jimi Hendrix style kind of furious sound, was a thing called a mini Cutron, which is an electro-harmonics pedal, and like an old Chandler tube driver, which is like a valve distortion thing, and then a load of like Echoplex tape echo. You know, just loads of kind of old rickety things that you know, break down as often as they work, really. But they produce, because they're such kind of organic things, they produce very kind of unpredictable sounds.
And when you look at this album compared with the first album, I mean, how would you describe the progression in the sound of Keane?
I think it's a much more varied album for a start, which is something we were really determined to do. I think looking back, we felt Hopes and Fears was a bit sort of you know, even though we're very proud of it, it's a bit kind of one-paced almost. And, you know, so we wanted to try and have a huge range of sounds. But it's generally the sounds, I think, a lot more, I don't know, I guess it's a lot more rock, it's a lot more rhythmical and a lot sort of sexier and a lot, I don't know, the sounds, I think, are really kind of dark, basically.
I think it was almost a record that kind of just burst out of us, you know, with Hopes and Fears. Like you say, you know, we had a long time to prepare, and you know, there was a kind of collection of songs from quite a few years, but you know, we spent such a lot of time together, sometimes great and sometimes bad, you know, and in the last couple of years. And you know, when you kind of distill all that kind of energy and passion and turn it into a record, you get this kind of raw sort of snapshot of you know, the way that we've been feeling and the things that we've experienced over the last couple of years. And in that sense, I think it's a more kind of visceral album than Hopes and Fears maybe was.
Well, it's great to see you again. I'm going to throw it back to you guys. We've got about 10 minutes left. I know you've got a couple of songs. I don't know how we're going to fit them in, but I'll let you keep an eye on it. We'll come back about a minute before 12 noon. We'll give away some copies of the CD as well. I guess someone who becomes eclectic or keen.
Behind you.
Great to see you guys, as always. Good luck with the new record and all that it might bring you this year. I'm sure you'll be touring the world again, and hopefully we'll see you. It's every year, November 2003, June 2004, September 2005, June 2006. So I'm guessing we'll see you in, like, March next year or something.
Let's hope so. Great.
Congratulations, guys. Thanks.
Thanks, Nick.
Morning Becomes Eclectic at 89.9 KCRW. As we wrap up our program for the morning, we thank you for joining us. Thanks to the band Keane, to James Evans and Brent Reinecke at Interscope Records. Adam Tudhope is the band's manager. Ray Guana was our sound engineer this morning. Ian Slater, the band's engineer. Jessica Spalding, I should say, our sound intern. Marty Matulis, our web video producer. Special thanks to Jason Groman. Ana Ibustios is our production assistant in studio on Thursdays. Ariana Morganston produces our program. And tomorrow, Isabel Campbell will be our guest in a session that was actually recorded probably a couple of weeks ago, I think. A couple of months ago, we've been sitting on that one. So we'll bring you that tomorrow. This is KCRW Santa Monica, KCRI Indio Palm Springs.